Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. I come from Guizhou Normal University. You know that Guizhou Normal University is located in the on the plateau, Guizhou Karst Plateau, in the southwestern part of China. The topic of my presentation is synthesis and the characterization of mesoporous graphene, reduced graphene oxide based nanocomposites for the photocatalytic degradation of xylenol orange. In this study, we also used artificial intelligence aided experimental design. As we know, graphene materials own the advantage of high electrocatalytic activity, high conductivity, excellent mechanical strength, and a strong flexibility, large specific surface area, and lightweight. There are many three forms of graphene: graphene powder, graphene film, and the graphene liquid. Applied, the graphene are very commonly applied in photocatalysis, hydrogen fuel cells, lithium ion batteries, and solar cells. Graphene is an ideal carrier for loading nanoparticles. Dyes are used in daily life. You know, dyes we today in my work, I used that graphene-based nanomaterials to remove dyes in wastewater. Dyes are usually are very commonly used in daily life, biology, medicine. Advanced science, industry, and agriculture, which were found to be, some of them were found to be carcinogenic, toxic, and mutagenic. A small amount of synthetic dyes in wastewater is very obvious because, you know, it just show color, just give a little bit in water, wastewater, you can show very clear color. Of course, it's kind of a pollution. Xylenol orange, you know, this structure. So as a component of a coating, where it's widely used in industry production, which lead to industry wastewater pollution, and it belongs to phenol, the three phenol structure and the chemical properties are stable and difficult to degrade. But the structure kind of like this, different type of. These are properties of the XO, the xylenol orange. So we use something 576 nanometers for measurement. calibration curve. We used it in ppm level. This is a schematic illustration of a charge transfer mechanism of a zinc oxide mechanism doped zinc oxide. You know, when use a ultraviolet UV irradiation, we can get a pair of hole and electron spare of hole and electron. Then this material will reaction with water will produce free radical, OH free radical. You know, this is very active. It can destroy or oxidize many type of pollutants, such as xylenol, orange. Here is a when the particle is loaded on graphene, reduced graphene oxide sheet. Then this is the mechanism of xylenol. The xylenol orange removal. Methods, we use, these are synthesized. This nanocomposite was synthesized with the three steps methods and were characterized with using XRD, SEM, nitrogen sorption, TM, Raman, PRO, photoluminescence spectroscopy, and UV visible DRS analysis. Then, after synthesized, we also, of course, we use that the material for removing dyes, and then we use a response surface methodology to design. Then we use artificial intelligence technique, platform modeling, to the removal process of this dye. The predicting its maximum removal efficiency. Use a dye, we synthesize material and characterize materials. Then we use response surface methodology to design the removal process. Then we use AI to optimize optimize the results. Then get the best the removal efficiency. And the best conditions. The experiment data were analyzed by using Langmuir by different kinetic models. We use two kinetic models, Langmuir, Kenshawood, and through the second order kinetics models. We use, just now I mentioned, we use a response surface methodology. You know, central composite design is one of the most important method in response surface methodology. Using this method it should be more efficient and easier to be arranged and interpreted than other design, because response surface methodology is kind of graphical program. So you can see that observe easily, observe easily. It can effectively reduce the number of experiments. Of course, as this is just similar to many other experiment design methods. They're able to show the interaction effects of variables. Artificial intelligence just imitate, actually imitate as human brain. It has many advantages. As we know, AI is a revolution, is revolutionizing our human society and will cause huge impact in the future. This artificial neural network, firstly, it can effectively describe multivariate nonlinear problems with the suitable amount of data. Secondly, it can be an effective tool for predicting and optimizing any complex processing parameters. Thirdly, the capability of self-learning and self-adapting. As we all know, artificial intelligence can be widely used in autonomous driving, computer vision, speech recognition, and machine translation intelligent assistant. It actually have been very widely used in our society in many areas. Now one of the major techniques we used in recent work is ANGA. Just now we mentioned that. And now we're discussing about GA. GA is an algorithm that imitates biological evolution model to obtain the best individual. And the algorithm describes a natural selection process in which only the best individuals can survive. Actually, genetic algorithms just imitate a human genetic systems. Another technique is a particle swarm optimization. This swarm optimization is kind of just imitate the birds behavior for foraging. Actually, it means food, looking for food, different birds looking for food in some random way. This is imitate the birds looking for food. This is a schematic diagram of backpropagation artificial neural network. We can say we have three layers. You know, this input layer. This is hidden layer. This is output layer. In hidden layer, we have five neurons. We can say, you know, from the input layer, we have the connections to different neurons in hidden layer. You can see just from first layer to second layer, then from second layer to third layer, something like a straightforward, okay? We can say that we have no lateral connections in different layers. This means that fade forward, but the arrow is back propagated from here to here to here. We do not see any lateral connections from different neurons in same layer. These are results and discussion. After synthesis of the nanocomposites, we use a X-ray XRD to characterize. Now we can see different. Here is GO X-ray XRD pattern. Here is a zinc oxide. This is a magnesium-doped zinc oxide. This is reduced graphene oxide-based nanocomposites. here, this is a nanocomposites. It's clear, more, it's a resolution, high resolution. It's high, you can see the results. From this, we can see the, you know, the, these components of crystal components of this material and the composites. Then we use SEM to check the particle. Here is a GO. First, we get a GO supported ferrofluoric oxide, ferrofluoric oxide. Then we get a zinc oxide. Here is the distribution of particle size. Here we can see the mechanism doped zinc oxide. The size of the particle is quite large. Here you can see the particle is much smaller. You can see that the particle is something like a 15 something, okay. Here, you can see particles are much bigger, several hundred nanometers. So when we support the graphene zinc oxide, that then size will become much smaller. Here we in this slide we can see the sorption, nitrogen sorption desorption curve. Here is a something like a type 4. So we think this side, this curve, this belong, this the structure, the curve, the pore of this material, inside the material, belong to mesoporous because it belong to four type of nitrogen desorptions, sorption and then adsorption and desorption curve. Then we can say PDH pore width, something like a close to three. And we can say strong distribution here, strong pore size, strong pore in at something three nanometers. So this is nanocomposites. So we can judge this material has the pore, mesoporous pores mostly, mesoporous pores, because it's something like 3 nanometers, the pore size mostly distributed in this. You can clearly see here from here, very strong distribution. This is a photoluminescence spectroscopy of nanocomposites. This nanocomposites, you can see here is something like a 400, you know, several peaks here. Here we can see UV visible diffuse reflectance spectrum of these nanocomposites. We can see here is a zinc oxide, magnesium doped and zinc oxide. Here is a nanocomposites. We can see it's a little bit red shift. So it means that this kind of a support, this kind of a nanocomposites can useful as a, used as catalyst of the dye removal, because it's a little bit, can say a little bit redshift ahead. Here is a Raman shift, Raman's spectral. Here is a, this is a G-graphene oxide. This is a reduced graphene oxide based nanocomposites. We can say the G, this is a G-band. This is a D-band. After the supporting of the nanoparticles on graphene, reduced graphene oxide, we can see D band becomes stronger. It means that the support is this support is very clear. This loading is correct, very clear. Here is a magnetic. We can check the magnetic, use a squid, check the magnetic properties. We can find that from this hysteresis, magnetic hysteresis, we can say this belong to, this material belong to hard magnetic material, not soft. And also the properties, quite magnetic property is quite strong. So which can be used for magnetic separation, something like a 20 EMU, I mean, saturation magnetism. It's quite high. Here is a response surface methodology modeling. This is a data. We can say the model, p value of the model is small, very small. So it means that this model is significant. This RSM based model is significant for this removal process, dye removal process. Here is the response surface methodology, CCD graphs. The red color from the light color, red color, we can see the removal efficiency is high. Color is deep. If color is deep, is a removal efficiency is low. Light color is means bigger removal efficiency. This is pH value. Okay. Use this four. There are four parameters, so we get some six. Six graphs. This is time, dosage. This is pH concentration. This is three-dimensional curve. This is pH and dosage. This concentration, dosage. This is a flow diagram of back propagation, artificial neural network training. You know, from data, from RSM, CCD data, then we begin the training. There are four parameters. We begin a training, then we get obtain the weight and the bias. Then we can predict the degeneration efficiency and calculate mean square error. When results get, the results meet, if the results meet the criteria, then we get a convergence of the network. And training, This is predicted values. This is predicted values. This is experimental values. Predicted values, variant values. Then we get at the regression. We get a regression curve. The results are quite good. R something like a one. It's quite a good results actually. Here is a different neurons of a neural network from a different MCE. Actually, this neurons is something in hidden layer. Hidden layer from one, you can change the number of neurons in one in hidden layer from one to 10. Then we check the MCE. Then we get at a five. When number of neurons in the hidden layers, something like the five, then we get best results. Here's the importance of different variables. We use the Gaussian, Gaussian method based on the weights and the bias from the neural network. You can see time, pH value, concentration, dosage. So we can say concentration is number one in the importance of variables. This is number two, dose is number two, and the pH is number three. This is number four. Time is number four. This is a genetic algorithm optimization at the particle swarm optimization. Here we can say something like you can say it's a take something less than 100 generations, then GA genetic algorithm get converged. But here we get the iteration, different iteration is something like several less than 10. My iteration, we get a converged, particle swarm optimization get converged. Comparison of different models tells that now we get from this results, we get this study, we get this nanocomposites is something is controllable, synthesized. Then this results, this is a BET surface area, something it's quite big, it's something 90. And this pore size is something 2.5. So it belongs to mesoporous. And the particles with the average size, something like that's something 13. It's quite uniform, distributed. Under optimized condition, the maximum xylenol orange degradation, something like that, 96%, it's quite high. Absolute error is low. The results indicate that the process of xylenol, the XO belong to legomyl, cancel wood model. The evolution variables show the dice concentration gives the maximum importance to degradation of the xylene concentration is the most important for degradation of xylenol orange. The future aspects, we use AI, different head of one methods to get better results. This future, our future plan. This is my, thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.